We now know of two new studies that agree blood type O makes you less vulnerable to contracting the virus. It also says if you do get the virus, it's likely going to be a more mild case. So how exactly is this possible? Joining me now live is internal medicine doctor Brian Lamb. Dr. Lamb, thank you for joining us.
Oh, thank you for having me on tonight.
A lot of people see this in the news and they think, why does a person's blood type matter when it comes to the coronavirus?
So this is something that we've been looking at, and we're trying to see whether your blood type gives you any sort of protection from actually contracting the disease. What the studies have shown is that people with type O blood may not get as severe a case in all situations. And it's very important that we say this. This by no means means that you have any immunity. People with type O blood should not take this as a free chance or think that they won't get sick. You still can get sick and you can still die no matter what type blood type you have. There might be some slight innate protection by having type O blood is all the study is saying.
So when we hear lower risk, how much lower are we really talking?
It's lower risk. It's lower risk, but it's not as significantly lower. There is by no means any immunity. That's the important thing to realize. They are not saying that you are immune to the disease. Okay. You may have a slightly lower risk by percentage points.
How often do researchers study the link between blood types and the severity of diseases?
We do this a lot. We do it with a lot of different diseases. One of the most well-known cases of this is malaria. We know that certain blood conditions actually protect you from getting malaria, and that's why certain blood conditions such as sickle cell anemia has actually been shown to be beneficial in people in regions that have high infections of malaria. So this isn't new.
Do we now have more people calling, trying frantically to find out their blood type because these studies were released?
We do. We have a lot of people calling, trying to find their blood types. What we usually try to remind people is that it's not a routine test. Your doctor usually doesn't know what your blood type is. It's not something that we normally check. If you really want to know what your blood type is, the best way to find out is to donate blood. It benefits you because you'll find out what blood type you have, and it just helps so many people.
Dr. Lamb, we appreciate you for taking the time to speak with us tonight.
Thank you for having me on.